There have been 11,107 people to serve in Congress since it started, and Madison Cawthorn might be the very worst one. I will explain for the smart people. If you're an idiot, feel free to stop watching and just mash your keyboard a bunch in the comments. First, the backstory that proves that Madison Cawthorn is more than just an unqualified violent liar. Cawthorn's first involvement with politics came when he was 18. Cawthorn procured a recommendation to the United States Naval Academy from his local congressman. The congressman was future insurrectionist and Trump Chief of Staff Mark Meadows. Aside from being a traitor, Meadows is probably best known for being fined by the House Ethics Committee. Why? Meadows continued to pay his chief of staff, months after he was fired for being embroiled in sexual harassment allegations. Anyway, Meadows was an investment client of Cawthorn's father's firm, which is most likely how Cawthorn got his recommendation. What's the best way to prove that a homeschooled douchebag is eligible for the prestigious United States Naval Academy? Why, having his father make money for a congressman, of course. The Naval Academy, however, disagreed. They rejected Cawthorn's application, as they absolutely should have. They rejected Cawthorn like they were one of the many, many women to accuse him of sexual assault. But more on that later. Cawthorn would later deny that he was rejected from the Naval Academy, and blame his not attending on a car accident. An accident that happened after he was already rejected, because Madison Cawthorn is a liar. Despite not being admitted to the Naval Academy and not attending high school, an 18-year-old Cawthorn took a spring break trip to Florida. I guess he needed a break from his rigorous schedule of being rejected by colleges. On the long drive back, Cawthorn and his then-best friend both fell asleep. At 5 p.m., an hour into the drive, they must have been exhausted from all of the various legal activities they did. The car hit a concrete barrier. According to their depositions, Cawthorn had no memory of the accident. Meanwhile, his friend said he helped rescue an unconscious Cawthorn. And that was the story, until Cawthorn changed it so he could look better. But more on that later, because Madison Cawthorn is a liar. The accident took place in April of 2014. In early 2015, Cawthorn was given a part-time job in Meadows' office for a year. Cawthorn later described that job as full-time and 2 years, because Madison Cawthorn is a liar. Cut to fall 2016, Cawthorn enrolled in Patrick Henry College, a teeny school in Virginia with 300 students. So Cawthorn was working full-time in North Carolina, but still somehow going to school in person in Virginia, because Madison Cawthorn is a liar. Cawthorn took his $3 million settlement and used it to pay tuition and to buy a house in the area of the school. It seemed for a moment like Cawthorn was taking his future seriously, doing everything he needed to do to invest in his academic prospects. Except doing any work or being a decent human being. Cawthorn dropped out of Patrick Henry after just one semester with a D average and a litany of sexual assault allegations. By Cawthorn's own story, his poor grades were due to cognitive impairment from a brain injury. So he's so cognitively impaired that he couldn't even maintain a C-minus average at a school of 300 students. But he is somehow qualified to legislate? Like his female classmates told him many times, absolutely not. A letter signed by more than half the student body at Patrick Henry alleged that Cawthorn committed vandalism, lied habitually, and routinely sexually assaulted his classmates. Seems that Cawthorn was trying to give his classmates a different D than his teachers gave him. According to the letter, quote, Cawthorn's time at PHC was marked by gross misconduct toward our female peers, public misrepresentation of his past, disorderly conduct that was against the school's honor code, and self-admitted academic failings. The letter goes on to detail Cawthorn painting himself as helpless, to get women in a car with him before driving them to a secluded area, locking the doors, and making unwanted physical advances, repeatedly. And again, this letter was signed by more than half the people he went to school with. It makes sense. If Cawthorn believed that no means no, he'd have accepted his rejection from the Naval Academy. Cawthorn denied the letter and amassed signatures of his own. A whopping 6 students, 3 of which worked for or were related to someone who worked for Cawthorn's campaign. Cawthorn also implied that he had the support of Patrick Henry's president. Patrick Henry's president denied that and asked publicly to not be associated with Cawthorn's signatures, because Madison Cawthorn is a liar. I need to point out that the original letter did not come out during the primaries. This was not one of Cawthorn's political opponents convincing people to sabotage him. This was after he was already the Republican nominee. A heavily Republican student body in a heavily Republican district decided to come forward about Cawthorn's past. It was so important for them to stop Cawthorn from being elected that they risked giving a district to a Democrat. What does it take to make such an impression on a student body that 3 years later, they sign a letter against their own political interests to try to stop you? It takes being a monster. And speaking of that, Cawthorn sued the auto insurance company for his accident. But he also sued his best friend. Cawthorn said that his friend, quote, left him to die in a fiery tomb, which other accounts claim didn't happen. Cawthorn also said that he was, quote, declared dead on the scene, which definitely didn't happen, because Madison Cawthorn is a liar. Cawthorn's own account of the scene was that he was asleep before the crash, and then the crash left him unconscious, and then he was declared dead. Yet he also claims he remembers how it happened. Maybe Cawthorn was conscious, but he's just so dumb he seemed unconscious. Or, more likely, Madison Cawthorn is a liar. In 2020, Mark Meadows left his congressional seat to become Donald Trump's chief of staff. Cawthorn ran for the vacant position. Meadows, Cawthorn's former mentor, didn't just endorse one of Cawthorn's opponents. Meadows illegally used taxpayer funds to help her. Meadows is also a monster, but I'll delve into that in another video. So how did Cawthorn win against a Republican establishment candidate, supported both by the outgoing congressman and Donald Trump? By lying. Because Madison Cawthorn is a liar. Cawthorn lied about his accident to make himself look like a victim. Cawthorn lied about his rejection to the Naval Academy to make himself look like a patriotic sailor. Cawthorn lied about his academic record to make himself look like a scholar. Cawthorn lied about his history of sexual assault allegations to make himself look like he wasn't being accused of sexual assault by half an entire student body. But it didn't stop there. Cawthorn lied about there being a group of cartels at the Mexican border kidnapping American children and selling them into slavery. Cawthorn lied about journalist Tom Fiedler, who had investigated Cawthorn, and insinuated that Fiedler was a race traitor for criticizing a white candidate. Cawthorn even lied about his Trump-endorsed opponent, somehow claiming that she was a never-Trumper. And it worked. Cawthorn won and became the youngest congressman in 60 years. A 24-year-old habitually lying, violent, cognitively impaired alleged sex offender, and somehow, he's in Congress. But wait, it gets worse. In 2017, Cawthorn took some of his settlement money and went to Europe. While there, he visited the landmark that every white supremacist dreams of, Hitler's vacation home. Cawthorn didn't just happen upon it. Hitler's home was Cawthorn's destination, a self-described bucket list item that he proudly shared on Instagram. Just in case that's not gross enough, Cawthorn has a shell company with no income and no employees other than Cawthorn, and it's called SPQR. SPQR was a symbol of the Roman Empire, and is an abbreviation commonly used by white nationalist groups. Cawthorn justifies it by claiming it's just a term for Rome. Now, that is not a guarantee that Cawthorn is a white supremacist. Maybe he's just a guy who left college after one semester with a D average, but is somehow interested in history when it comes to white supremacy. Sure. And maybe he locked the doors of his car to protect those women. But wait, it somehow gets worse. Cawthorn, without any proof, repeatedly claimed that the 2020 election was ripe with fraud, even though that was the same election that put him in Congress. While speaking at Turning Point USA, Cawthorn encouraged people to threaten their representatives to overturn the election. And it wasn't just at Lollapalooza. Cawthorn spoke to the crowd the morning of the January 6th insurrection, and encouraged them to fight. Of course, he later claimed that January 6th was a false flag operation, and it was caused by Democratic agitators placed within the group, because Madison Cawthorn is a liar. Cawthorn also recently claimed that he was invited to cocaine-fueled orgies by Republican representatives in their 70s. I don't believe that either. I mean, yeah, those orgies probably happened, but I don't think anyone would want Madison Cawthorn there. Cawthorn's irresponsible rhetoric has encouraged violence against elected representatives more than once. And he even went as far as to say, quote, "If our election systems continue to be rigged and continue to be stolen, then it's going to lead to one place, and it's bloodshed." But there was one even worse. He told mothers, "If you are raising a young man, please raise them to be a monster." Well, mission accomplished, Priscilla Cawthorn, because boy does that describe your son. Cawthorn is so evil, even Mark Meadows abandoned him. And Meadows usually likes guys that are credibly accused of sexual assault. Cawthorn was stopped for trying to illegally smuggle a gun on a plane, and then tried to smuggle another gun on another plane. Cawthorn called women earthen vessels, which explains why he doesn't care whether or not they consent. Cawthorn parroted false Russian talking points about Ukraine. Cawthorn even claimed that he couldn't attend a congressional vote due to fears of COVID, while actually attending CPAC, because Madison Cawthorn is a liar. Cawthorn constantly beats the drum of his alleged traditional Christian values. He has a history of anti-transgender comments, including from the House floor. He voted against the LGBTQ protections in the Equality Act. He called educating children about gender and sexuality, quote, indoctrination. And yet, pictures surfaced of him wearing women's underwear. Let me be clear about this. The problem that I have with Madison Cawthorn wearing women's underwear is not the act of wearing it itself. It is his blatant hypocrisy and deceit. Madison Cawthorn can go himself wearing whatever he wants. And now that I've made clear the pattern of Cawthorn's constant dishonesty, I want to add that Cawthorn is not just a liar. He's even more dangerous, because he's an extremely gullible liar. According to Cawthorn, he met his now ex-wife Christina, a gorgeous fitness model, in an extremely convoluted way. As his story goes, Cawthorn was traveling in Scandinavia when he decided to just pop down to Russia. While at a casino in St. Petersburg, he met an army captain named Todd, who he hit it off with. The two remained in touch. And then, a year later, Todd invited Cawthorn to a fake CrossFit competition, which was actually a ruse to introduce him to Christina. The two hit it off, and the rest was a storybook marriage that ended in divorce just 8 months later. Anyone who is not an idiot has so many questions. How did Cawthorn just pop into Russia last minute, when you need to apply for a visa well in advance of a trip? How did he end up at a casino in St. Petersburg, a city that has no legal casinos within 1,000 miles? What was a US Army captain doing gambling at an illegal casino in Russia? Why would a sex-obsessed cretin like Cawthorn need to be tricked into meeting a gorgeous fitness model? And of all ways to get a paralyzed Cawthorn in the same room as Christina, why would a CrossFit competition not arouse suspicion? Perhaps that's just conspiracy, and all of these questions have legitimate answers. And they in no way have anything to do with Cawthorn parroting talking points from Russia about Ukraine. And if you believe that, you probably believe that Cawthorn was accepted into the Naval Academy. Cawthorn is guilty of stolen valor, lying about his naval acceptance. Cawthorn is guilty of threatening violence against elected officials, of suing the friend that pulled him from a car wreck, and of racist conspiracy to stoke fears about immigrants. And Cawthorn, by his own admission, is guilty of forcibly kissing a minor, and very likely guilty of sexually assaulting multiple women. And again, by his own admission, Cawthorn didn't even have the cognitive abilities to pull a C average at a small school with an acceptance rate at 14% higher than the national average. Is it extreme to say that Madison Cawthorn might be the worst person to ever serve in Congress? Considering that Marjorie Taylor Greene and Lauren Boebert are currently serving, maybe. Steve King was an unapologetic white supremacist. William Jefferson pocketed money after Hurricane Katrina. And Dennis Hastert stole funds for hush payments to young boys who he molested. In the 233 years of Congress, I'm sure there are tons of evil people that you and I have never even heard of. But I can say for certain that Madison Cawthorn is exactly what he encouraged mothers to raise. Because Madison Cawthorn is a monster. Thanks for watching. This was for the smart people. Thanks for watching my videos. If you enjoyed this video, tell me in the comments. Make sure to follow me on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, and everything else. If you want to see videos like this before they are released, check out my Patreon, patreon.com/Steve Hofstetter. And I'm back on the road. Come see a live show. Tickets and tour dates are at stevehofstetter.com.